An empty mind flare vessel. If its occupant survived, they're nowhere to be seen.
Their tracks. Its nest must be nearby. That stench. Dead owlbear prey, no doubt. Looks like a shrine to Saluna over there. There's magic keeping this chest sealed. I can feel its aura. This thing won't yield its contents easily.
You feel the quake of its heavy footsteps before you see it. An owlbear, its beaked face looming out of the darkness. The owlbear's one good eye flicks away for a moment. You follow its glance and see an owlbear cub. It sits back, its eyes still fixed on you. A silent ultimatum. You can leave now or step closer and die.
Here we go again.
The cub looks from you to his dead mother. A single strike will end his suffering.
It hurts.
You watch, speechless, as the cub begins to eat his mother.
The cub has a fighting chance now.
That, or we've just prolonged its misery.
These are supposed to be worth a fortune. More owlbear eggs, already hatched. No point in taking these.
Lazelle has a dangerous look in her eyes. Let's just hope she reserves.
Fine. What's on your mind?
If you're sure.
Though you seem to know what you're doing, I suppose.
Oh.
Oblivious to your presence, the cub continues to gorge himself on his dead mother.
Your kind will punish you for consorting with us.
My name is Lazel Chokin. And my kin will understand my new self. They will have
only strange. It looks healthy.
The pig's dead, my friend. Staring at it won't bring it back. Come on. We'll never fix these brain worms if we stop and gawk at every piece of carrion you find.
Seems to be fresh, only a few hours dead. Examining the corpse, you see two small puncture wounds in its neck.
And is it dead enough for you? It's been drained of blood with wounds in its neck. It's been killed by a vampire. I didn't want to say anything because I didn't want to worry you. They are ferocious creatures. But don't worry. I'll keep watch tonight. We won't have to worry about nocturnal visitors. Now please, let's go.
For you,
Lazel. I know they do not. It is my responsibility to cleanse myself.
Not a chance I'll fit in there. Not a chance I'll fit in there.
Punish someone who wronged you.
Wrong me how?
Say, murder or theft.
Killing is good. It culls the weak. But theft would be paid for painfully, 1,000 times over.
Good to know.
I'd have to be a lot smaller to squeeze in there.
The dog lowers his hackles, his head tilted inquisitively. Convinced that you're harmless, he turns his attention back to the corpse. The dog whimpers nervously, as if to urge you on. The dog looks at his owner with sad eyes. He does not move. The dog sniffs your hand, his tail swung low in understanding. He knows how to find you. Dog watches the corpse, a quiet whine escaping with every breath. The dog whimpers nervously, as if to urge you on. The dog looks at his owner with sad eyes. He does not move. The dog sniffs your hand. His tail swung low in understanding. He knows how to find you.
Tell me, Lazo, you say we might be purified and more fresh. What does that mean exactly?
Augusto will affix the safest. The purifier to our heads.
Its magic will overpower that in an instant. Your sour face is tired.
I'd rather not turn my back on you, if it's all the same.
So, do you have loves waiting for you once this is all over?
Dead goblins.
You know what?
Dead travelers.
They're not the easiest of questions for me to answer.
You mean just waiting? Like a lovesick puppy? Short-term amusements are much less hassle.
To tell me a bit more?
An intricate device crafted by Millar, our most gifted artisans. I am sworn to say no more.
West Baldur's Gate, East Elturel.
So, you and Lazelle. Please.
Something's waiting up ahead.
Moonhaven.
Tell me, Lazelle, what is it like on the astral plane? Your home realm intrigues me.
Moonhaven.
Githyanki lay their eggs on other planes.
Moonhaven.
Get over there! Surround them like! You spotted us. Good. It's like they say. No fun in skewing a pig what doesn't know he's cooked. That's supposed to be a threat. Got a set on you, all right. Almost makes me like you. Almost. I'm gonna enjoy pulling off your skin when we're done.
At the ready.
Victory awaits. Taking position.
Death is but a word away. Knight to King 5.
To focus. On the move.
Shall we cut and run? Let's go.
Another day, another fight. Here goes nothing.
Time to strike.
Long day. I'll need to rest soon. Let's have a look at myself.
Together. Aren't you, Dan?
Sure. in silence.
You sniffing where you ain't ought to be, friend. Might have to take that nose.
A strange symbol glows, marked on their flesh, and something within you stirs in response.
Funning around while I'm stuck dealing with yobs. Enough.
What's inside?
Battle is remarkable, as is your battle stance itself.
Rathajack, a technique known to few outside Kalir. Shall I teach you?
I'll pass, thank you. I prefer abjuration over acrobatics.
No time for mercy.
Time to deal some punishment. What if this crash doesn't work out, Liza? What if your kin fail you?
If I can reach the crash, my kin will provide.
Spare me a moment, if you please. I've something important to discuss with you. We've been traveling together for a while now, and it's just about time that I shared something with you. It's a rather personal matter that I'd prefer to keep quiet, but needs must when the devil drives. I have no choice but to speak. You see, I have this condition. Very different from the parasite we share, but just as deadly. The specifics are rather personal, but suffice it to say that it is a malady I've learned to live with, though not without some effort. What it comes down to is this. Every so often, I need to get my hands on a powerful magical item and absorb the weave inside. I can say no more on the matter. Not now, anyway. Just trust me when I say it's all of vital importance. It's been days since I last consumed an artifact, since before we were abducted. It is time, and by that I mean it's imperative that I find and consume strands of weave at the earliest possible juncture. As luck would have it, you're already primed to give me exactly what I need. Thank you. Oh, that hit the spot. I can feel it work. The magic, it's like a lullaby that sings to sleep the demon inside. A metaphorical demon, I haste to point out, but no less dangerous. And no less bound to wake up again to continue its ravages. Such is the nature of all monsters. Grateful as I am, the course of our camaraderie is much better served by not taking that particular detour. Not just yet. Sincerely, though, I understand I ask a lot from you with few answers in return. But in time, all will be told.
My lord, I bow to your boundless kindness.
So, Gale just consumes magical items like I do wine. We truly are a group apart. Nevertheless, as quirks go, that's a new one for me.
got a long road ahead.
Thank you. How can I help?
No time for mercy.
Just another crate. Looks empty.
Thank you.
I do not know this name. If you are known to my master, step forward and declare yourself an ally.
There is a pause as those glass eyes take you in. Then...
a well-guarded laboratory.